Good morning, students. See, we are learning photochemistry, and in photochemistry we are interested to know how the chemical reaction takes place in presence of light. Now the efficiency of these photochemical reaction depends on how much quantity of radiation will cause what quantity of reactions. So based on that, we are measuring the yield, that is commonly called quantum yield or quantum efficiency. So in today's session we are going to learn and what is meant by actinometers and different types of actinometers. Actinometer is a device which is commonly used to measure intensity of radiations. It determines the number of photons by measuring the rate of change of photo induced response in a chemical system. The first actinometer was invented by John Herschel in 1825. The physical devices like bolometer, photodiode, photomultiplier is used, which converts energy of incident photon to electrical signal. However, chemical actinometer is used most widely, in which quantum yield of reference substance undergoing photochemical reaction is determined and calibrated. So chemical actinometer, to measure the quantity of radiation absorbed, photosensitized reactions are commonly used. As the quantum yield of photochemical reaction is given by quantum yield equal to rate of reaction divided by rate of absorption, or the number of molecule decomposed or formed divided by number of quanta absorbed. The fractional light absorption is measured by using actinometer. The number of photochemical reactions is suitable as actinometer, and they useful in specific wavelength range. So now let us see different actinometers. Generally four actinometers we are going to learn. The first actinometer is ferric oxalate actinometer. Parker and Hatchard, they developed this particular actinometer by photo decomposition of potassium ferric oxalate. It is most accurate and widely used actinometer, covering a wavelength of 250 nanometer to 577 nanometer. Irradiations of ferric oxalate solution reduces ferric to ferrous, which is estimated colorimetrically by using orthophenanthrolene as a complexing agent. The optical density at 510 nanometer is measured, which gives a deep red color, and compared with the standard graph, the measured quantum yield shows negligible variations with the temperature, composition and light intensity. Its quantum yield varies from 1.2 to 1.1. Second actinometer, which already we have learned, is uranyl oxalate actinometer. It works in a wavelength range of 208 to 435 nanometer with the average quantum yield of 0.5. Here, and see, this is actually a less quantum yield, but it is easy. Here UO2 plus 2 uranyl ion act as a photosensitizer. In this actinometer, solution of uranyl sulfate and oxalic acid is used. Here a light absorbed by colored uranyl ion caused decomposition of oxalic acid as shown in the reaction. The extent of decomposition is measured by titrating against standard KMnO4 before and after exposure. The third one is MGL actinometer, that is malachite green leucocyanide. It is used in a range of 220 to 300 nanometer. On irradiation of MGL, it converts to Mg plus ion, that is malachite green plus ion, cation, which has very strong absorptions at 662 nanometer. The quantum yield for production of Mg plus is 0.91. The last actinometer which we are going to learn is Rennick salt actinometer. It is a convenient in visible range that is 360 into 735 nanometer. Rennet salt is available as ammonium salt with the formula NH4 thrice Cr, NH3 twice NCS. It is converted to potassium salt. On iridiation, equations of a complex releases thiocyanate. The quantum yield is calculated as the moles of thiocyanate released per instance of light absorbed. The pH is adjusted between 5.3 to 5.5. The quantum yield is found to be 0.27 to 0.30 in visible range. Thank you.